Problem 3. The system of forces acting on a crank is as shown in the figure below. Determine the magnitude, direction and point of application of the resultant force. Point of application is nothing but position. So it is the given figure. We need to find out magnitude of the resultant, that is R is equal to question mark. Then direction theta is equal to question mark. Then point of application of the resultant force, point of application is nothing but position. So if you want to calculate the position, you need the point. Here they have not mentioned any point. In the given figure, we have four different points like A, B, 5, O, D and C. So let us take the position with respect to the O. You can choose the point when the point is not given in the problem. So I'm going to calculate the position with respect to the O point. Now, we will follow the same regular procedure for non-concurrent force system. First, horizontal angle theta and splitting up the inclined forces. Then sigma fx, sigma fy, then r and theta. Then to find out the position, calculate the sum of the moment with respect to the required point in our present problem, that is with respect to O. Then perpendicular distance L is equal to sigma m by r, x is equal to sigma m by sigma fy, y is equal to sigma m by sigma fx. We will follow the same procedure. Now first, horizontal angle for inclined forces. Out of the four forces, the 500 newton is the inclined force. The horizontal angle is already given, so no problem. Next, splitting up the inclined force. How to split? This is the arrowhead. Behind the arrowhead, draw nearby horizontal line and nearby vertical line. So splitting is over. Next step is sigma fx and sigma fy. Calculate sigma fx, that is given by horizontal force and horizontal component. I will start from this force. The horizontal component is moving rightwards, so positive. Horizontal component is f cos theta, that is 500 into cos of 60 degree. Then vertical component, leave it. This is vertical force, leave it. This is also vertical, leave it. Horizontal, it is leftward, so minus 700. So if we calculate, you are going to get it as minus 450 Newton. Then calculate sigma fy. I will start from this force. Horizontal component, leave it. Vertical component coming downward, minus. Then vertical component is f sin theta, that is 500 into sin of 60 degree. Then vertical, so it is minus 1000. Vertical downward, so minus 1200. It is horizontal, so leave it. You are going to get the value as minus 2633 Newton. Sigma fx, sigma fy is over. Then we need to calculate r and theta. So r, it is given by r is equal to square root of sigma fx square plus sigma fy square. Sigma fx is minus 450 whole square plus sigma fy is minus 2633 whole square. So you are going to get the value as ...2671.17 Newton. Then calculate theta, that is the direction of the resultant, that is given by tan inverse of sigma fy divided by sigma fx, where fx and fy are positive. We need to take the positive values only. So sigma fy, we got minus 2633. Let us take the positive value, plus 2633 divided by sigma fx minus 450. Let us take plus 450. So if we calculate, we are going to get the value as 80.3 degree. So r and theta is over. Next, we left out with the position of the resultant. We'll calculate it here. Next we need position. To calculate the position, first we need to determine the sum of the moment with respect to the required point. Since in the given problem no point is specified, so we are going to calculate the position with respect to the O point. Sum of the moment of all the forces with respect to the O point. Before going to this, I am going to tell you some concept. Like moment means force into perpendicular distance, F into D. If it is rotating clockwise, it is positive. If it is rotating anticlockwise, negative. Then if the force is passing through the moment center, then the moment will be zero. These are the three things you need to keep in mind while calculating the moment. And another concept is, we have some inclined line with some distance L, and the inclination is theta with respect to horizontal. We have an inclined line of dimension L and the horizontal angle is theta. Then the horizontal component and vertical component of this inclined line is given by, horizontal component is L cos theta, vertical component is L sin theta. So like the inclined force, we can calculate components for inclined dimension also. Once you understood this concept, we will proceed with the problem. Now calculate sum of moment of all the forces with respect to O point. I will start from this force. Here the horizontal component, here the inclined force acting at point A. So the horizontal component will act here. It is passing through the point O, therefore moment is zero. Then vertical component. Vertical component is F sin theta, that is 500 into sin of horizontal angle 60 degree. It is acting here at the point A. Now the perpendicular distance between this force line and this point O is how much? 150 plus 150, 300 mm. Then with respect to the point O, rotate the another finger in the force direction. It is rotating anti-clockwise, so it will become negative. Keep your one finger at the O point, that is the moment center, and rotate the another finger in the force direction. You are going to get the clockwise or anti-clockwise. Clockwise is positive, anti-clockwise is negative. Then next force is 1000 into perpendicular distance between this 1000 and O point is how much? 150. And it is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, so it will become minus. Then next force is 1200 into perpendicular distance between this 1200 line and point O. We need nothing but this horizontal line we need. We have the inclined distance, that is 150. Horizontal angle is 60 degree. So the horizontal component of this inclined distance will become L cos theta. If we consider this one as the inclined length L and the horizontal angle theta, therefore horizontal distance will become L cos theta, that is 150 into cos of 60 degree. This is the force and this will be the perpendicular distance. With respect to the point O, it is rotating in the clockwise direction, so it will become positive. Then next force is 700 into perpendicular distance between this 700 Newton force and point O is how much? We need the vertical component here. Here the total inclined length is 300 mm, horizontal angle is 60 degree. So L is given, theta is known, then the vertical component is L sin theta, that is 300 into sin of 60 degree. And how it is rotating? It is rotating anti-clockwise, minus. If we calculate, you are going to get the value as 3717 69.15 newton meter. So once it is over, we can find out the distances. The perpendicular distance L is given by sigma MO divided by R. Then x-intercept is given by sigma MO divided by sigma FY. Then y-intercept is given by sigma MO divided by sigma FX. That is equal to, so sigma M is 3717 69.15 divided by resultant value. We got the resultant as 2671.17. So if we calculate, you are going to get the value as 139.178, and here all the distances are in millimeter, so it will be also millimeter. Then x-intercept, sigma M is 3717 69.15 divided by sigma FY. We got it as 2633. Take the positive value only. So you are going to get the value as 141.2 millimeter. Next, y-intercept, sigma M is 3717 69.15 divided by sigma FX. We got it as -450. Take the positive value, so +450. We are going to get the value as 826.15 millimeter. That's all for this problem. Thank you.